Well, Nigel, it's good to ask not if you're going to make a new signing, but to talk about a new signing. Tell me a bit about Taylor and the process of bringing him to Ashton Gate.
Well, look, we just are always on the lookout for players who potentially going to make us better. I mean, we've currently got players who are missing. So with Ross and Taylor's played at right back as well, gives us some cover there. He plays in midfield, and Yule has worked with him before, so he's aware of his strengths too. So yeah, it was just an opportunity for us to get something done relatively quickly. So we're very pleased about it. It gives us an option in the short term, but of course we have options as well, which is good.
Yeah, described as a defender and a midfielder. Do you, in your mind, have a preferred position for him, or do you expect him to be a versatile member of the squad?
No, I think it's just one of those where he's a good age for us. Like I say, versatility gives us a bit of cover where we're currently short. So I'm very pleased. And I have to say, I've been very impressed with him as well.
Did he meet his teammates for the first time today?
He was in yesterday.
Okay.
So, yeah.
And it's a loan with an option to buy. Is that just something that suits all parties?
Well, the clauses have all been agreed. So if we decide to take that option up, then yeah, it's already done. So it's and I think that gives him as well something to aim for as well. He's really looking forward to the challenge of coming here, and he's been trained very well today.
And he ticks all the boxes because he's young and no doubt can improve, but he's also got experience, hasn't he, well?
Yeah, he has. So, yeah, he's a decent signing for us.
Prospects of more incoming, I know it's ongoing. Realistically, what are you expecting over the next week?
Not a great deal, if I'm honest. It's we're pretty happy with what we have, and I've already explained on numerous occasions what the circumstances are, so I'm not expecting to be told that there's scope to do anything else. So there we go. I'm not expecting a lot, and it's important that we try and keep our squad together as well.
How do you reflect on Saturday? It was off the back of a very encouraging win at Millwall.
Yeah.
How do you reflect on the game against Birmingham?
Frustrating, disappointing. I think we were very underwhelming, really. I think that's the most disappointing thing about it, is that we weren't able to show the real commitment to go and win the game. And consequently, to come away with nothing in a game where we fell for a sucker punch at half time, didn't create enough, and when we did create, we didn't take the opportunities. So yeah, very frustrating day for us. But as I've said to the players, they're the same group that had put in a really professional performance the week before. So let's make sure it's just a one-off, eh?
And when you're looking for a response, how much of it is on the training ground this week? How much of it is in the mind of the players?
It's about being able to perform on match days. That's all it's ever been about. So I've never been a fan of players who are good on the training field and can't play on game day. It's about being able to perform on game day. That's the most important thing. And we let ourselves down last week. And of course, we're all disappointed about that, because it spoiled what was a reasonable start to the season. But it's going to be something that we're going to have to get used to. I mean, we had more or less 70% possession, which just proves possession doesn't mean a great deal if you don't make good use of it, or you don't grind your opponents down. And that's what we needed to do. we were just very careless on the day, and that's, yeah, unfortunate, but move on.
In terms of team news, I think you spoke to the written press about Ross. Can you just clarify how long you expect him to be unavailable?
No, I don't. Well, I don't know.
You don't know?
I don't know. But I think it's looking more likely that it will end up with surgery. So, but time frame I've got, I don't know.
We're used to hamstring injuries and thigh injuries. Is this a bacterial infection? What's the actual issue with Ross keeping him out of the side?
Well, I don't think that that's something that I can disclose in the public domain. It's not, you know, I don't. It's something that's very unusual and very, very unfortunate. But, you know, I think medical records should be left in the private domain, not the public domain.
Totally respect that. He must just be very frustrated. Yeah,
he's really frustrated.
Yeah. And as are you, I'm sure, because you've bought a player to the football club and you've not been able to use him so far.
Yeah, but that happens. You know, look, all I've said to him is the most important thing at the moment is he comes back fit and very, very difficult situation for him to deal with, because of course he started pre-season very, very well. He was looking forward to getting his career in England going, and we're going to have to be patient for him. So.
Andy Vyman got 60 minutes. Yeah. Is he going to be in contention to be available in the squad on Friday?
Yeah, he will. Yeah, so, which is good news for us. We've got, he'll be back in the squad. So, it's a bit of good news for us, eh?
And I promise I'm not Mr. Negative, but obviously no Rob on Friday. So, what kind of problems or issues does that create for you as you look to replace him in the centre of defence on Saturday? Because you've got options on Friday.
Yeah, well, I mean, it's just something that we deal with. We've got options with full-backs playing in there. We've got options of midfielders playing in there. We don't have a lot of cover there at the moment, but we will manage. It's because we've got to. So it's part and parcel of a league season is to have players missing either through suspension or injury. Of course, I wouldn't have it this way so early in the season, but you know, like I say, you got to deal with these things, and I don't really waste a lot of energy thinking about it. Just thinking about how we shape up and make sure that the team performance gets us over the line in a game, because that was the problem last weekend. We weren't efficient enough as a team and not always brave enough in possession. So we've got to find those answers again.
And Hull, couple of back-to-back wins. What will they provide you as a challenge on Friday night?
Well, they're a decent side. They've got some good players. And it's a ground that we were very frustrated at last year. Our opponents are always going to cause us a problem or a potential challenge, but as again referring to last week, it's what we do that's the most important thing. So we know that they are they're a possession based side. They can they've got some good technical players. They can mix the game up too. They've got players who are running behind as well. But it's what we do ourselves, and we've got to make sure that our positive side to our play is very evident. So there may be more opportunities on the counter-attack against a side like Hull, but who knows, they might want us to have the ball.
And I recall interviewing Liam Rossini here at Bristol City. I imagine his dad was someone you'd have had battles with in the past.
Yeah, but I've worked with Liam as well. He was a player for me at Hull, so a really bright lad. I think he's got a bright future in the game. It will be a difficult game for us.
Yeah, I spoke to his dad in the week, and he said that even at a young age, he had aspirations to be a manager. Is that something you saw in him when you worked with him?
I thought it would be more media myself.
He's good at that as well, isn't he?
Yeah.
Thank you.
Pleasure.
When you talk about the transfer situation, if you like, and you use the term we're happy with who we are, I appreciate you're talking about and you like to emphasise the club as a whole. I just wondered if you're happy personally where you are in terms of your options in the squad.
Well, it's where we are where we are. I can't. It doesn't matter what we would all like to do in an ideal world, but our budget is at the limit, so we can't do any more. So it's not about that. I've got every faith in the players that we have, and as I've already pointed out many times, it would be very, very expensive to improve on what we've got, unless something like this week happens with the deal that we've done with Taylor, which is a very positive one for us. But we're at the limit of what we can do, so it's like saying, would you like to manage one of the top 5-6 teams in England? It's, you know, of course you would, but it's not going to happen.
You mentioned on Saturday about the opportunity for a loan, kind of with reference to right back. Is that was Taylor the player you were talking about when you said that on Saturday, or is that something else that you're doing as well? Just to clarify that.
No, this was something that we were talking about. Yeah.
Okay, and just finally, on the transfer side, obviously you mentioned about Rob's suspension, the lack of options in there. That's not a consideration between now and the end of the window. That area of the
pitch. Yeah, we don't really have the ability to go and do that. Because, as I've said, you know, we're at the end of what we can do financially. So there aren't really options out there for us.
No, loans wouldn't be possible.
But they could still cost money.
Well, that was what I was going to say.
Yeah. So I think people think about budgets as being how much cash have you got to spend on fees. It's not that. We're talking about the whole aspect of it, and that is wages. So, you know, we're not in a position to do any more business in that regard. And I don't want to lose players either.
Is that something that could happen?
Well, I don't know. It depends on whether somebody comes in for a player, doesn't it? But you know, hopefully, if somebody does come in for one of our players, the club doesn't allow that to happen. Because if we lost a player, we haven't got a lot of time to do much. So, you know, those are the parts of the equation that I don't think people factor in too many times. So, we're not able to go and do any more business, really.
Okay, just on Andy, sorry, missed a 60 minutes.
Yeah.
Have the number 9 in his back, playing as a central striker. Is there anything to be read into that, or is that just simply a case of getting him in the team so he could play?
Yeah, he wanted to have a run there, which is good. It's good for us. I mean, it wasn't a great game for us and for him, but the most important thing was to get some, just to test his heel out, to make sure he was okay, and get a bit of match time in, I suppose, as much as anything. And he looked fine in that regard. Bit of a frustrating day because we didn't really create anything, I think it was a useful exercise for him to make sure in his own mind that he's okay. And of course, Andy's played in numerous positions for us, so gives us another option.
And given kind of what you said about squad options, and it's unlikely that anything will be done between now and the end of the window, a lot of the lads, the younger lads, not like Keane, but the younger lads who people may think might go out on loan, is it fair to assume that most may be staying in house then for the season? Or is it?
Well, if they stay in on this window, it doesn't mean they, you know, it could be a January situation. When you look at how our players develop, it's You know, this place, the title of this place is the High Performance Centre. Why would you necessarily send players away from here where we have no guarantees that what they might get is some men's football and a bit of old-fashioned character building by being in not-so-good surroundings, which in itself could be a good thing for one or two. But our players are developed here, mostly. And we use the loans market, the loan option for our players to go out when we think it's the right thing for them in their stage of development. I think some of our younger players who have been in and around the first team during pre-season, you know, they may at the moment struggle in men's football away from here. Could make them, but it could break them also. And I don't think it's the right thing to do to generalise about players. So it used to be the way that when you get towards the end of pre-season, start the season, send them out on loan and see what happens. We only send players out when we think it's suitable for them and it's the right way to push them on to the next level. Apart from that, they're better in-house with us because of how close the academy is now to the first team operation. You know, the communication's so thorough that we're aware of where most of the players are, or all of the players are at, really, in terms of their needs. And so yesterday's game for them was a bit of a livener, let's put it like that, against a very, very good side who played, you know, they'll get more out of a game, or they'll learn more in a game like that than they will maybe going out somewhere and being stuck on a bench. I remember Sam Bell going to Grimsby and he scored a goal and then he just basically sat on the bench. For me, that's a waste of time. You know, that's and I don't expect managers of clubs who are at whatever level people are working at, they're all trying to win games. And so why would you make promises that you're going to play a player in a side when you can't make that promise? So actually, you know, every player's needs are different. There are good places to send players on loan, and there is a right time to send players out on loan. But we don't feel at the moment that you know, that there are too many that will benefit. But that will change over the next couple of days. There might be one or two players who do, but they'll only go out because it's a short-term situation.
Ayman wasn't involved.
Who?
Ayman Benarous wasn't involved. Has he still got a minor injury, or was that?
That's
still the case. So he would have played had he been, potentially.
Yeah. Well, you were away last week, weren't you?
Yeah, I know, but no, I was going to pick up because you said that, and he's got a minor injury.
Yeah.
Obviously, yeah. Minor.
Well, minor compared to ACL.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah.
But I just wondered if.
He'll be out for a few weeks.
Okay.
So.
Okay.
But
I'm
again.
I'm trying to join the dots to see if he can be contented for Friday.
No. And we'll be very. We'll be careful with him because I think it's important for. And I've said this before with him, when you've come back from two major injuries like he has, you know, the psychological aspects of a further setback can be very, very, not just disappointing, but it can be a bit demoralising as well. And so we just need to make sure that he doesn't have further setbacks. So, you know, we'll take care of him.
With Rob Atkinson, I appreciate it. So it's a complex process. Is there any kind of sort of clarity in terms of what I don't want to use the word expectation, but what could happen with him in terms of his timeline?
Not really at the moment, and there's no point in me sort of making it up because I don't know.
Yeah, absolutely.
And it's not something I've discussed recently. His recovery is going very, very well. You know, again, because of he's a big fella. you know, he's not one of these light, wiry players. But he's doing really well, and again, it's really most important for players like that that they aren't rushed back. You know, I want players to stay back once they return. I don't want to sort of be trying to fast track players in there because we're a bit short on players. So we'll have to manage, and that's how it is. Again, I suppose what it does with Taylor coming in, it gives us options in centre back position just because of the full backs that we have. Both George and Cam did very well when needed last year, but I'd prefer them to stay where they are actually, because I think they've, generally speaking, both done very well. So yeah, we'll just see how that goes.
Just finding an injury, Tommy Conway, is there any further news regarding him?
No, he's again doing well, but I can't remember what time frame we put on that to start with, but it'll be about 10 weeks, something like that. 8-10 weeks, something like that. So how many weeks ago was that? I don't know.
Yeah, that sounds about right.
Yeah.
on the centre back thing, and I know you're not going to say one
go on.
The other, but obviously Cal finished the game in there.
Yeah.
On Saturday.
Yeah.
I think it's very natural to sort of consider that he could start.
That's right. Yeah.
I don't think he's really second half of the season. He tended to be in the field.
Yeah.
Because of the let's just say the challenges he had.
Mm.
Is that a sort of part of the thought in terms of, because he looked so comfortable in midfield, and obviously he looked uncomfortable, but he was put in uncomfortable situations at times in defence. Does that come into it, or is it something that you're just not in because you've got full faith in him as a professional?
Well, of course I've got full faith in him, but also, you know, it's I think it's always important for players to simplify the game. You know, he's an experienced player, so you know, when players change position, it's really important that they don't over elaborate in positions like that. So probably something that's isn't valued enough these days, and that is, you know, I think when you look at a lot of youngsters, especially defenders who make their way in the game, there seems to be this obsession with them being comfortable on the ball, and actually they'll make a living from being reliable defenders. And people like me pick defenders because of what they can do. So I think this is something where, you know, and it's a complex thing because, of course, we're, you know, we're in academies now, and rightly so, the limit the amounts of impacts, especially with headers, etc., which I understand in many ways. But the art of defending is still as valuable today as it's ever been. Probably not valued enough. In the more fashionable areas, but for me that's a load of rubbish because, you know, you need players who are able to do a job for you. So, whoever plays there at the weekend will know exactly what's expected. And the most important thing is that we function well as a team. And that's it, as far as I'm concerned. If it's an ugly win, it doesn't matter. But, you know, we need to get back to winning ways just because we owe ourselves a performance after last week as much as anything else. We want to be a success.
Thanks, Sasha.
Okay.
Just on Efren, you mentioned Saturday, you liked what you learn from him in that game and his cameos so far as well. I just wondered, from those cameos and seeing him every day in training, what are the key traits that he possesses?
His raw trait is pace. And when you've got pace in the modern game, it gives you a start. On top of that, he's got a really good mentality. He's a quick learner, and he's got bags of enthusiasm. So even last weekend when he went on, as a wide striker, he tracked. He nearly prevented the second goal. You know, he sprinted basically 70 metres back and, you know, almost prevented it. But so he shows the, not just the technical attributes, and shows promise in that regard. He shows the right attitude, mentality, and I'm very pleased that he's firstly broken into the first team setup, and hopefully he'll have a positive season with us.
Yeah, and you mentioned possession on Saturday, but not quite being able to break Birmingham down. Now, that's kind of been the story.
Well, when we did, we didn't make the most of it. So, you know, had Naki have scored when that chance came, bearing in mind we were down to 10 men and they got three players down with cramp, even with 10 men we outran them. But what we didn't do, we didn't create chances in the game, which we could have done if we'd have been a bit brighter with the ball. And that is, I expect our players in wide positions to want the ball and get the ball and do something with it.
And you mentioned commitment briefly earlier from that game. You talked about bravery after the Preston draw as well. How much of that can be coached, or is that kind of just down to the players on the day to be brave?
Well, look, you can coach what you want during the week, but what you can't do is you can't be inside a player's head. So if a player doesn't want the ball, then you have to ask that question to the player. So unfortunately, the two games had similar traits to them, and that is, when you've got the opportunity to give your opponent a real test in wide areas, you've got to want the ball then. So, and we didn't, often enough.